Thanks for tuning into the Stocks to Watch segment. And we bring in closer to the market open time simply because there are a clutch of stocks that will be in focus today, not just at the morning at 9 a.m. or 9:15 a.m., but for the better part of the morning as well. Telcos, you guessed it right. We'll talk about all about them. Where is Joshi Johnson right now to speak about these? And there are one piece of news and one big judgment that will come later on. Mahiresh, one quick factor. Do you think the markets will have any role to play? Because yesterday there was a bit of a nervousness due to the China LSE issues or due to the new margin funding rules. But the SGX is indicating a start, which is likely in the positive. So therefore, market will stop being a factor for the telcos, you reckon?
The factors that you spoke about, I think the market should probably take that into stride over the next few days. So I think we'll go through an adjustment phase. But the market will probably gestate all the factors within that. So I think the telcos will not probably get much impacted in this swaying of the market spend.
Okay. So now first, let's talk about 9 a.m. or 9:15 and then talk about 11:30. So 9:15, Mayuresh, Indus Tower Bharti merger goes through. Now, how do you read into this? Because, I mean, Vodafone gets this cash consideration, okay. But are the companies preempting that Vodafone will survive?
So that's the moot question, right? And again, Neeraj, I think the whole premise is based on the fact of the survival for Vodafone Idea, because I think the tenancy decline that you've probably seen for the tower players, including Bharti Infratel, the Vodafone Idea exit has probably impacted them in the previous quarters as well. Now, the survival is extremely critical for them to maintain the tenancy ratios, because if that exit happens completely, I think you know what kind of an impact and a multiplier impact that can have. Therefore, I think the prime moot question here is what the judgment probably comes through. And if these companies do survive, I think the tower companies then have some breathing space itself.
But would you reckon, I mean, Vodafone has been in a bit of a tear the last two sessions, and now it's at 10.20 or thereabouts. Do you reckon this announcement itself, ahead of the AGR verdict, could have a positive impact on Vodafone?
So sentimentally positive for the tower company itself, Neeraj.
Okay, but I think the entire,
but the entire premise here is in terms of the periodicity of what the Supreme Court probably dishes out. So again, I think the ARPU increases is a given. So irrespective of any time horizon that comes through, I think the ARPU increase is going to come through for not just ensuring that the kind of dues that are expected to come through, the kind of leverage that has got built on their balance sheet, but to ensure that the EBITDA probably stays above water for all these companies as well. So irrespective, I think the ARPU increases is given for these companies. And entirely, I think the periodicity, I think, will determine how the banks will also react, because on the survival of telecom companies, the recognition of what banks have done will also and solely will determine.
Okay. Mahiresh, now there are two key things when it comes to the verdict today by the Supreme Court, right? One is the staggering of the payments, which will be impacting both Bharti and Vodafone. And two is any decision, if at all, on the past spectrum dues, which will have an impact on Bharti and Reliance. Now, what is it that you would watch out for? None of us know what the outcome will be. But what is the key thing that you will watch out for the three telcos today?
As you rightly pointed out, Neeraj, I think the time periodicity becomes extremely critical, and what the court will probably dish out will be known at 11:30 in the morning. But larger the time period of what the telcos have been demanding 20 odd years, I think that does alleviate the kind of pain that their balance sheet is already existing, because they still need to pay the dues off in a staggered fashion over the next few years. So I think if the time horizon is extended to 20, I think the kind of pain that these companies have gone through, I think it creates some alleviation on that front. I think if it's around 10 years that we're talking about on the lower end of the range that we're talking about, the kind of expectations that you will have, and as I said time and again, I think the ARPU increases will be in a far larger proportion if it's a lesser time horizon, maybe in a far more calibrated manner if it's in a larger time horizon. So I think the end user is obviously going to feel the pinch in terms of larger increases. But I think that will be mandated, because if the court decides a time period in the middle on whatever decision that it makes, it creates some amount of alleviation in terms of ARPU increases that these companies can take. And if they can take those calibrated increases, the kind of churns that is expected probably also minimizes. But I think it's now become a three-floor player field, at least till the judgment is out, and at least at this point of time. So I think it entirely depends in terms of the time periodicity. And based on that, I think the kind of ARPU increases these companies will take.
Can Vodafone and Bharti take price hikes if Reliance Jio is not doing that.
So that's an outside risk, Neeraj, and therefore I think if they need to probably ensure that their balance sheets are healthy. Now, comparatively, if you probably look at debt EBITDA levels for Bharti and Idea, I think Bharti is still in a comfortable position compared to Vodo Idea at this point of time. Again, the kind of expectations that one really has, there is not much choice left, right? Because I think a lot of the capital raising modes have already been explored. A few options have already got monetized. Therefore, the most logical conclusion remains, irrespective of what probably comes through, they need to go through and take those ARPU increases. And it aids Jio as well. So if these two players are going to take their hikes, Jio will also come into the field. Because as I said, I think it's going to be a limited player field. Where I think if one player is taking that, the other player follows. I think the third player will also ensure that if ARPU increases are happening, that strengthens its cash flows and balance sheet as well, without disrupting too much in terms of how the end users are feeling. Because they're ultimately going to pay a little bit more in terms of subscribing for data services or voice services as well. Therefore, I think it's part and parcel, and that should get gestated in terms of all the players probably hiking it to an extent that it ensures balance sheet comfort for all.
Just keep in mind, after today, two big events for Bharti Airtel would be out of the way. The MSCI selling got done yesterday. So that negative is done. And now the AGR verdict, whatever the verdict is, will be done today. And then the future ahead, as Mayuresh is saying, would probably depend on ARPU increases. It might be at a tactically very strong 200 day moving average level of about 509 or 505, whatever it is. And therefore, this one could be an interesting stock too. Mayuresh, last question on Moil. They've taken some price hikes, etc. It's not a stock that usually comes up in conversations. So, but if you track Moil, then that. If not, then on the other metal names, what are your thoughts?
No, so absolutely. I think what Moil has done just yesterday, if I'm not mistaken, they've increased their prices of grades by 10-odd%, whether it's Ferro, the SMGR grades, so on and so forth. Interestingly, I think manganese, ferromanganese, and silicomanganese, all these alloys are used for iron and steel manufacturing. When I was going through a lot of data points in the past few days, steel exports, in fact, have increased quite substantially. And in fact, China has been one of the biggest buyers apart from Vietnam for Indian steel. Iron ore prices have exceeded $130-140 a ton, which logically leads to the conclusion that end steel prices would also start increasing. Now, as a process, as manganese starts getting used for these metal manufacturing as well, and because of the hikes that they've taken, I think it's a sentimental impact on the stock. The second impact is in terms of the global production. So I think South Africa is one of the largest producers of manganese, accounting for 34-35%. With the coronavirus, with the supply chain disruptions thereof, I think even the global prices have probably seen an uptick, which is logically rising and leading to the price increases that you have here. So I think end user probably holding up from data points that we are seeing. Prices probably expected to hold up because of global supply issues. I think that is what might prompt sentimentally the kind of moment that one expects in the Moil probably.
Okay, Mayuresh, it will depend on 11:30 in a big way. Thanks so much for joining in today and giving us your thoughts. Really appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you so much, Neeraj. Thank you.
Yeah, pleasure is ours. And viewers, thanks for tuning in to this Stocks to Watch. Well, let's see how they react this morning.